A very warm welcome to all of you on behalf of Google Developers Group. It's exciting to see a hall full of people and few of them are standing behind. A bright Sunday morning and a hall full of developers. What could be even more beautiful for us to see? So myself, Nikita Gandhi, I work as a project coordinator at Google. I work for the Google AI team and we work for making education programs for different categories. So I'm a part of Explore Machine Learning team, which makes content for university students, which can help them learn machine learning in which they can use machine learning to build some viable products. Recently, our team launched a curriculum for university students in India. Last Sunday, there were 65 students shortlisted from all over the country who gathered together for the launch of the curriculum. And India is the first country where we are piloting this curriculum. That is what I do at Google. I'm very passionate about making education open for all, and this is what I do in my daily job as well. Insert some free motivational quote here. So I was just trying to be formal, just like another keynote speaker will be, and maybe I'd not find something as practical when I read a few quotes on internet, so I have just kept it structured, but there's no content that I found. Okay, so what are communities? In simple English, what are communities? Communities is a gathering of people with similar interests, similar circumstances, or similar people who are living in the same region, right? And communities are strong when they are connected to each other mentally and emotionally, right? Communities are not rhetoric. Communities are built with the help of emotions and passion and interests that people share together. And where communities is a group of people who come together and apply similar actions to change the world. We all know there are a lot of communities that are run online. Stack Overflow. All of you use Stack Overflow intensively? So everything that you need to know, anyone is free to ask questions and anybody is free to answer those questions. Isn't it a strong community where you can openly ask questions, where you can openly answer to the questions? Maybe your answer is wrong, but the platform is open for all, right? Quora, just not technical questions, but you can just ask any question that you have, right? And there are other more communities that are run online. This is for the technical world. And offline, there are local meetups, something like what we are a part of today. But here comes the question, do we really need a community? Yes? How many of you feel like, do you really need a community? Interesting. Now if I say this community removes the hat of Google developers, this community removes the choice of getting support for swags and pizzas from Google, how many of you will like to come and be a part of the events? Interesting. But is this something that you really want when there are so many online forums? Why do you gather together? What is the purpose to gather if there are so many online forums? Anyone in the audience would like to answer? Yes. But forums like Stack Overflow, we have members from all over the world, and there are so many people online. You can get your answers on the go. Okay, answering the questions on the go. Okay. Any more reasons for a community gathering in person? Yes. Know each other in a better way.
Online, there is a flow of
Flow of sentiment, yes.
Knowing each other.
Okay. Now, if I ask you a question, what is the purpose for you to gather today? Is it learning a new technology? Is it about networking with fellow like-minded people? Is it the community service or is it the speaker profile? Which one will you most vote for the most? Networking. Learning new technology. Then what about community service? Are we serving for the society? As engineers, are we helping the society? How?
Thank you so much. So what happens is, suppose I am working on something called X, and there's someone who's working on Y. So if that X on which I'm working can help the person who's working on Y, don't you think it'll be beneficial to them? Don't you think we'll be serving to the community directly and
yes,
helping someone?
You can meet and motivate each other. You
exactly.
can inspire each other.
Exactly.
So a few days back, I created a Twitter survey where I asked the same question. And here's what I got to know, which is pretty much similar to what you answered. 48% people think that they want to attend a meetup because they want to learn new technology and network. But are we being selfish enough? Are we only thinking about ourselves, or we also have to think on a broader scope as citizens of this country? Okay. When it comes to forming a community, a homogeneous community will maintain a consistency. It's always okay and fair enough to think that you wanted to work with like-minded and equal-headed people who have equal skill set, right? Nobody wants to work with someone who doesn't have the right skill set. Nobody wants to work with someone who doesn't think like the way he or she does. And it's fair enough. But inclusion makes it happen, and here's a wonderful example where GDG Kolkata collaborated with other forums to make this event a huge and grand. And that is why they could make this event successfully happen, because it helped them in getting sponsors, it helped them in getting more number of attendees and volunteers, right? They have a variety, they could gather a variety of people attending this meetup. So many of you are interested in mobile. So many of you are interested in AI and ML. There are so many women attendees, while there are so many beginners and professionals attending this meetup. Cheers to the team who've worked hard to gather an inclusive audience. A big round of applause for the organizing team. Just excuse me, please. Sure. Okay. So what do you exactly do when you gather for a community meetup? Connect and build relationships. Help each other grow. There are so many experienced professionals who would like to help the beginners so that they don't face the issues that the professionals experienced while they began their journey. There are so many of us who have so many questions unanswered in terms of our professional career. And there are so many people who have gone through similar experiences. Connect and help each other. Grow together. Maybe someone who has a lot of professional experience but has lacked the learning phase because they graduated, say, sometimes 20 years back. The juniors or the beginners have the right way to tell you from where to get started, which is the most trending technology, which is the most trending technology that is helping them build something awesome. So never discriminate that how can a junior help me, or how can I reach a professional with so much of experience. Be brave to ask questions. Associate with each other as a community within yourselves, as well as the local community outside, with the social group of people who are facing issues. Think how you can solve those problems with the pioneer of technology. We, as engineers, should always think on a broader scope. How can we help the country to become better? We are serving the country by developing applications. Are we serving the country which can make lives easier with the unrepresented group of people? Appreciate. There are so many organizers today who work day and night to make this event happen successfully. There are so many experts who share their learnings in the form of content on YouTube, blogs, or community meetups. Appreciate the time that they spend in learning and sharing their knowledge with you. Be thankful to each other. Now, here's how you can solve for the local problem. So say, as a community, you see that there are so many problems that are unresolved and you can solve with the help of technology. Think about the user first. User comes in picture on the priority. The community, as a community, identify the problems that you can solve. Power it with the help of technology, improve the accuracy of the product, and build a trust within the social unrecognized communities which really need support. In that way, a community is going to be even more rich, who creates for everyone, designs for everyone, codes for everyone, and builds for everyone without any social discrimination. And this is my exam. This is how I would describe a community as an ideal community. Are we inclusive enough? A community who's inclusive enough in terms of just not gender, but experience, in terms of caste, in terms of political views, who gathers together for the right purpose, just not for ourselves, where we can come and learn new technologies. Just not learn new technologies, see how you can use them to help something, to build something useful. Gather together to grow together. That feeling is going to be even more rich when you help each other grow and you grow together as a community. I remember when Manisha started Kolkata community, it was just 5 attendees, and together now you've grown as a group of, say, 2,000 attendees who wanted to attend this meetup. So think, are you creating the right impact? It was just not about thinking that I want to learn a new technology, I want to network with people who can help me finding a new job, but think how you can create the right impact in the inside your local community as well as the outside world. Create an impression and think, are you being resourceful enough? Maybe you have something really interesting to share. Are we sharing the knowledge that we have gathered with everyone? And while we are doing, while we are serving for the community, be kind, be thoughtful, be brave, and be curious. And last but never the least, be thankful. Be kind to everyone. Maybe someone may not have the right accent to speak. In India, people may not know a proper way of communication, but do not discriminate. Try to understand what they are saying. Be thoughtful. Do not judge someone with the difference of opinions they have. Maybe they have a justified reason but not are able to express themselves. Be brave. Ask questions. Be curious. Like if Google comes with a study jam in front of you, say Flutter. Why learn Flutter when there's something called as Android which can also help you develop mobile applications? Is it just that it also helps you building cross-platform applications? So be thoughtful. If you're working on building something for the community, for the society, think if this app is going to be used by someone who's old, will they be able to use? Plan and make the right designs. Avoid using words like guys when there is a group of girls as well in front of you. Be thoughtful enough. Be curious. Ask a lot of questions. Who, where, why, how, what. These will help you think beyond the boundaries. And be thankful for what the community is providing you, for what the society is providing you. Okay. I'll just talk about how communities helped me for a few minutes. So when I was in second year, I came to know about this community called as Google Developers Group. Just like the name sounds wild enough, I thought this is only for experienced professionals, and am I the right audience to participate in this event? If I get inside the room, will people judge me? Will I lose the confidence that I have? And while I'm a beginner, am I supposed to go and learn new stuff? But somehow I gathered the courage. Somehow I thought, let's give it a try. And this has helped me a lot to become and improvise my professional skills. And I'll tell you how. So as a beginner of technology and being one of the most introvert personality, I sat in the corner of the room, a few of them are there behind. I was trying to hide myself, just not from the speaker, but the experts were sitting around me. And when I heard that they are building something so creative and innovative, I thought, am I still at the right position to attend, because I haven't started learning new technologies? I haven't even cleared my basics. Am I eligible enough to attend these type of meetups? But every other time I gathered the courage. Not all my friends were interested in attending community meetups. So I used to make random friends in college. Hey, this is an event that's happening around. Would you like to come and participate? And we used to sit in the corner just trying to learn what's going on. But when I heard that there were just not experienced professionals, but beginners who are building something innovative, that gave me the motivation to also work from something apart from my college curriculum. I gathered the inspiration from the fellow attendees. Learning new technology helped me building something innovative, something creative. And as I started talking to more and more people, I came to know so many questions that I had, and I did not know whom to ask, were getting cleared because I was talking to more and more people. So eventually the introvert in me started changing into an extrovert. I gathered the courage to come and speak in front of the audience. I developed my skills in public speaking. I became even more confident enough. Eventually, when I became an organizer for Women Techmakers Pune, it enhanced my leadership skills. It enhanced my time management skills, because there was an opportunity to attend or organize a meetup every month, and I had to manage time apart from my regular priorities to make these events happen. I could work with a variety of people while organizing this event. The meetups that we organized had organizers who were elder than me. There were organizers from different backgrounds that helped me to work with different types of people. So I eventually, the person who was sitting in the corner turned to become someone who comes up and speaks in front of, say, 800 people or 1,000 people, and communities is what I give all the credit to. 6 months back, when I had to decide, do I continue my job in coding, or I had an opportunity from Google to choose the role of project coordinator, I was very confused in the beginning. Everybody questioned me, are you really interested to leave your programming job? Because we've seen you being so passionate about programming, then why did you choose a job of a coordinator, which comes under the umbrella of management? What was it that made you take this decision? Not even my parents believe that I want to go towards a job of project coordinator, and believe me, it was just not because I was getting associated with a brand like Google, but serving the community for a purpose was the main reason I chose this job. So it's even more awesome to go home happy after your job when you know that you've helped people. Living life for a purpose is even more satisfactory. So there's a lot of joy in giving away. Just not think about yourselves, think about the community on a broader scope, and that will help you a lot in developing yourself as a professional on a broader scale. Maybe you can make your resume even more stronger in small amount of time. And here's a video that inspired me. Maybe not a quote, but a video that has inspired me a lot. There's some technical problem because of which we are not able to buffer the video and play for you. I'm really sorry for the inconvenience. Although the video was about Lakshmi, who comes from a rural area, who learns how to make fertilizers with the use of internet, and she helps her husband to make really good quality agricultural products apart from the conventional farming techniques which they used to use. So she concludes saying that she aspires to inspire the entire village with the knowledge she has gathered. So Lakshmi, who comes from a very small area of India, even has big dreams and hopes of inspiring the community around. I'm sure you all have an aspiration to inspire everyone. So gather together and work with a common purpose, aspire to inspire, is the message I'd like to share today. With this, I'd like to conclude my talk. I wish you a very happening Sunday today, and I'd like to pass to the next speaker. Before that, can we call all the volunteers and organizers and give them a round applause for the hard work they've done? Thank you so much for patiently listening.